Hello, and thank you for joining us for today's presentation on the American Housing Survey Table Creator. During this presentation, we will go through a brief overview of the AHS, and we will answer the following questions. What is the AHS Table Creator? What's included in the AHS Table Creator? How do you find the AHS Table Creator? And how do you create a table? Where we'll provide an overview of the Table Creator interface, and we'll walk through several demonstrations so you can see how easy it is to create tables with this tool. Now, let's get started. If you are familiar with the American Housing Survey, feel free to fast forward 9 minutes into the presentation to see the Table Creator demonstrations. About the American Housing Survey. The American Housing Survey provides a current and continuous series of data on selected housing and demographic characteristics. Policy analysts, program managers, budget analysts, and congressional staff use AHS data to assess housing needs by monitoring supply and demand, as well as changes in housing conditions and costs. The executive and legislative branches use analyses based on the AHS to develop housing policies. HUD uses the AHS to improve efficiency and effectiveness and design housing programs appropriate for different target groups, such as first-time homebuyers and the elderly. Academic researchers and private organizations also use AHS data in efforts of specific interest and concern to their respective communities. The AHS provides current information on a wide range of core housing subjects, including size and composition of the nation's housing inventory, vacancies, fuel usage, physical condition of housing units, and characteristics of recent movers, to name a few. These core subjects mostly stay the same from survey year to survey year. In addition to the core data, the AHS collects topical data using a series of supplemental modules. These modules vary from survey year to survey year. For example, for the 2017 American Housing Survey, the topical modules include eviction, delinquent payments and notices, disaster preparedness, and commuting. Summary tables are available on each of these topics. What is the AHS Table Creator? The AHS releases data to the public in two formats: the Public Use File, PUF, and the AHS Table Creator. The PUF is a group of data sets containing individual household responses to the survey questions that can be downloaded in SAS and ASCII formats for use in generating custom tables. Using the PUF requires a statistical program such as SAS, Stata, or R. Advanced data users use the PUF format to make more detailed cross-tabulations. The AHS Table Creator, on the other hand, is a web application that gives users the ability to access tens of thousands of pre-calculated tables from the internal use file, IUF, without having to download the PUF microdata or use statistical software. It allows users to cross-tabulate numerous tables with multiple by-group variables and two filter categories through a series of drop-down menus. Once created, tables can be downloaded in CSV or Excel format. What's included in the AHS Table Creator? The majority of the core tables in the AHS Table Creator are included every survey year, with only minor changes, so data users can track changes in important housing statistics over time. Select topical tables rotate in and out of the survey, depending on the survey year. The Table Creator includes the following topical tables: disaster preparedness, delinquent payments and notices, eviction, commuting to work by mode of transportation, annual commuting costs by type of commuter, health and safety characteristics, arts and culture, housing counseling, food security, public transportation, frequency of use and distance to public transportation, additional types of transportation, community involvement, movers and leavers entering unit, disability and home accessibility. And in Table Creator, you can build tables using national data or use geography filters to narrow the scope of your tables. Once you select a geography in Table Creator, the Select Year drop-down menu will show which years are available for that geography. To see what metros were surveyed in each year, See the metropolitan areas and years in sample document in the Help Guide section of the Technical Documentation page on www.census.gov. In Table Creator, the main data points that are used to build a table are referred to as variables. The majority of variables on the public use file are available in Table Creator, either as rows in each table or as column variables. Data are shown in thousands of housing units, unless otherwise indicated. For example, 121 million housing units will appear as 121,000 in the tables in Table Creator. The Table Creator is updated with new data every 2 years with the release of each survey. Additional updates are made frequently and can be found in the AHS Table Creator release notes in the User Notes section of the website's technical documentation. How do you find the AHS Table Creator? The AHS Table Creator is located on the Census website under American Housing Survey. To access the AHS Table Creator, click on the middle icon at the top of the AHS homepage that says Create Custom AHS Tables. If you are elsewhere on the Census website, type AHS Table Creator in the search bar. The Table Creator currently presents results from the 2011 through 2017 surveys. For data prior to 2011, go to the data page on the American Housing Survey site on census.gov. Overview of the AHS Table Creator interface, how to create a table. Now, let's walk through a quick overview of the AHS Table Creator interface. The Table Creator homepage provides easy-to-follow instructions on creating a table. First, select area. Options are national, selected states, or selected metropolitan areas. Then, select year. Select either 2017, 2015, 2013, or 2011. Because not all metro areas are sampled each survey year, data may not be available for every year in a particular area. Next, select the table. Choose one table from the dropdown. Tables are organized by topic and are a collection of subtopics with predefined rows or indicators. You can build your tables using up to two variables. To choose variable 1, select the first column variable or by group from the drop-down menu. If none is selected, only the total will display. For variable 2, select a second column variable from the drop-down menu. Selecting a second variable will result in column headings with nested categories. The majority of column variable options apply to all tables, but there are a few that are only selectable in combination with specific tables. For example, the occupancy or vacancy status variable only can be selected in combination with the housing unit characteristics table. You'll notice that some other column variables may be grayed out. These are column variables that either do not make sense with the table selected or that we may activate in a future release. Next, choose tenure. Tenure is a term we use to describe whether a home is owned or rented. The options are all, owner, or renter. Then, select the geography filter from the available geographies. Finally, select view. Options are estimates or estimates and margins of error. Once you are finished, click on the Get Table button to generate a table according to the criteria you selected. Click the Reset button to clear your entries and select new criteria. To download a table in Excel, click the down arrow icon at the top right corner of the Table Creator tool. Click the email icon to email the AHF staff comments or questions about the data or about the Table Creator tool itself. Click the question mark icon for help with using the tool. Now that you have some background information on the American Housing Survey and the Table Creator tool, let's create a few tables together. We've put together several scenarios to illustrate how this data tool can be used and its limitations. Let's start with creating a table using the national data. Example 1. In 2017, how many vacant manufactured mobile homes were for rent or for sale? First, select area, national, and select year, 2017. Now, let's select a table. Since we're interested in vacant units, we will select the Housing Unit Characteristics table. This is the only table in the AHS that includes characteristics about vacant units. It is also the only table that can be cross-tabulated with the Occupancy Vacancy column variable. Moving on to variable 1, select the Occupancy Vacancy Status column variable. This bigroup is the only way to get the number of vacant units. For variable 2, the AHS considers manufactured mobile homes to be a type of housing unit structure. So, for variable 2, we select the units by structure type variable. For the tenure filter, the only filter available for the housing unit characteristics table is all units, which is the entire housing stock, including occupied units, seasonal units, and vacant units. All other tables are for occupied units only. For the geography filter, choose All. Then click on the Get Table button. Let's look at the resulting table. Note that variable 2, units by structure type, nested under the variable 1, occupancy, vacancy, categories in the column headings. Since this table is so large and the column and row labels cannot be frozen, we suggest downloading this table in Excel for better readability. In Excel, the panes will be frozen, so you can more easily follow which data belongs to which column, row. Scroll down to the Homes Currently for Sale or Rent stub. There, you'll see a row labeled Up for Rent or Sale. To get the correct number of manufactured mobile homes, we will need to scroll over to the Total Vacant column spanner. We find that 44,000 vacant manufactured mobile homes were for sale or rent in 2017. Remember, the data are shown in thousands of housing units unless otherwise indicated, as is noted in the table's headnote. You'll also notice that some cells in the table have a period or are just blank cells. A period means there were either no cases in the sample or that the cross-tabulation is not applicable. A blank cell represents a true zero, and a Z represents rounds to zero. An S means the data are suppressed for data quality or disclosure reasons. These definitions are also found at the header of each table. Now, let's create a state table. Example 2. In Ohio, did owners or renters have more rodents in 2015? First, select the area, Ohio. Then, select the year, 2015. Now, let's select the table. Since rodents are a housing quality issue, choose the Housing Quality table. For variable 1, choose Tenure, which will give you both owned and rented units. In this table, we do not have a second variable, so choose None. For the Tenure filter, choose All. For the Geography filter, choose All. Then click on the Get Table button. Scroll down to the Selected Deficiencies stub. We find that 13.3% of owners, calculated by dividing the number of owners with rodents by the total number of owners, 399.2 divided by 2995.5 times 100 equals 13.3%, in Ohio reported signs of rodents, while 10.9% of renters, calculated by dividing the number of renters with rodents by the total number of renters, 172.9 divided by 1579.9 times 100 equals 10.9%, reported signs of rodents. Finally, choose the view. Select the Estimates and Margins of Error view to see the margins of error, which provide a 90% probability that the interval defined by the estimate minus the margin of error and the estimate plus the margin of error, the lower and upper confidence bounds, contains the true value. Now, let's see how we find data for a topic that isn't available in every survey year. Example 3. How many households in the U.S. have children ages 5 to 17 with asthma, and has that increased over time? Select the area, national, and select the year, 2015. The year always defaults to the most current year, and you can only select one year at a time. However, the data can be downloaded and compared in Excel. Scan through the table titles, which are organized by topic. If you do not see what you're looking for, select a different year. because the topical tables towards the bottom of the drop-down list differ by year. For example, the 2017 drop-down menu shows there are no tables with data on topics related to asthma. But when you select 2015 and activate the table drop-down again, you see that 2015 has a table titled Health and Safety Characteristics. Since asthma is a health-related issue, this table is where we are most likely to find asthma data. Select the Health and Safety Characteristics table. For variable 1, select None. For variable 2, select None. For the tenure filter, select All. For the geography filter, select All. Then click on the Get Table button and the table will appear. You'll see the header of the table provides the table title and universe of the table. Click on the Subject Definitions link at the top of the table to get stub heading definitions. Definitions are alphabetized by stub name. In this table, we can also see the 6 footnotes in the footer. Please note, the header of the table indicates that the data are in the thousands, meaning the table numbers should be multiplied by 1,000, except where indicated. If you look at the result in the table, you will see that 5,215 represents 5,215,000 households with children 5 to 17 diagnosed with asthma. To compare this to prior years, you must change the year in the Select Year dropdown. We already know this table wasn't available in 2017, so we'll select 2013. You'll see that the table dropdown list defaults back to the general housing table. This means the Health and Safety Characteristics table was not available in 2013 either. Select 2011 from the Select Year dropdown. You'll see that this table was available in 2011. For 2015 and 2011 can be downloaded separately and compared in Excel. Now, let's look at how to create metropolitan tables. Please be mindful that currently only one geographic area can be selected at a time. However, the data can be downloaded and compared in Excel. Now, on to example 4. Example 4. How many homes in San Francisco and Riverside San Bernardino with 3 or more bedrooms use a septic tank or cesspool? Select the area, San Francisco, and select the year, 2017. Note that when you choose San Francisco, the year automatically defaults to the most current year, but if you click on the Select Year dropdown, you'll see that data are available for 2015 as well, because San Francisco was also sampled in 2015. It is always a good practice to click the Select Year box to see what other years are available for a specific metropolitan area. Now, let's select the table. Since septic tanks are a type of sewage disposal, choose the Plumbing, Water, and Sewage Disposal table. For variable 1, choose Number of Bedrooms. There is no variable 2, so choose None. For the Tenure filter, select All. For the Geography filter, select All. Then click on the Get Table button. Scroll down to the Type of Sewage System stub. We find that 5,100 households in San Francisco had a septic tank or cesspool. You must add the 3 bedrooms column and the 4 or more bedrooms column to find the answer, 2.5 plus 2.6. Remember that the numbers are in thousands of housing units, so you must multiply by 1,000. Click on the Reset button and repeat the previous steps for Riverside. You'll find there were 84,400 units with septic tanks or cesspools in Riverside, 50.1 plus 34.3. On behalf of the Department of Housing and Urban Development of the U.S. Census Bureau, thank you for joining us for today's presentation on the American Housing Survey Table Creator. It's just one of the ways we're working to make it as easy as possible for you to use the AHS data in your work.